Just for this red, it's worth getting the palette.
I also have a fox.
Yes. Oh, I forgot highlighter. Really? Oh no. Let's be funky today. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, 5 looks with this gorgeous palette from VE Cosmetics. The Vixen. I already did an eye swatch video, and at the end of the eye swatch video I also gave you my review on this palette. It's not in this video because otherwise it will be way too long. This is what she looks like. I will link that video down below though, so that you can kind of check it out as well. So yeah, 5 looks. What I used as a basis of the looks are the different rows. So this is look number 1. But not completely, because I did allow myself to pull in other shades as I felt. That's basically what I want to say. So yeah, this is the last look I did. And this is largely the last row. But I did pull in some other shades as well. Timestamps will be down in the description box. I will also list the makeup that I have on my face in the description box. The base makeup will be the same. But yeah, eye pencil, lippy, falsies and all that. That will change during the entire video. And it will all be down below. That was rambly. I just need to stop this intro and insert look number 1. Because otherwise it will be 3 years long. So yeah, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up. Because here comes look number 1. I did my brows and I'm going to prime my eyes now with my Kiko Milano eyeshadow base, and I will show you once how I do that, and then it's basically the same after that. So yeah, let me just get some on my brush. I don't use a lot because you don't need a lot, and if you have discoloration, what I usually do is a little bit of concealer. Just a tiny, tiny layer to even out the skin tone. I'm going to start with my reference number 15 and the color the first shade. Going to use it as a transition shade. And I haven't set my eyeshadow base as you saw. So I'm going to tap it on first, lightly. And then I'm going to blend. It blends out very nice on a tacky base. And I know it is a wash of color now, but I'm going to build it up in a minute. Okay, now I'm going to build it up, still using the same brush. But I'm going to place it a little bit more low. A little lower, that was it. So I'm pushing my brush straight against my eye in my socket. And I'm going to blend Windshield Wiper Motions to build up the pigment. Cool. I'm going to go to a slightly smaller brush and the color together, which is also a red, but a little bit more muted and a little bit darker. I'm going to deepen up the crease a bit more. Because I still want to keep it red, I'm not going to pull in the black just yet. Maybe later, but not now. Now I'm looking down and I'm blending a tiny bit on the border of this darker shade and the previous one. Back to the first brush. I'm just going to make sure that everything is nice. It's very high up though, but that is all going to be okay. I do want to add a little bit of extra depth. I'm going to go to the black, which is called Fight. And I'm going to use a tiny bit of it to deepen up the outer corner and the crease. And then whatever I have left, I'm going to blend into the crease. Back to the second brush that I used and the color the first red. I'm going to sandwich it on top or put it... You know what I mean. You can see what I'm doing. I hope at least. Okay, shimmer time. I'm going to grab my NYX Glitter Primer and a flat brush. I don't want to be very precise, but a tiny bit. It's not rocket science, this actually. It's just swiping and tapping on your eye. That is it. Okay, I'm going to go into the the color that's giving me heavenly feelings. It's the color Is. It's the shimmer red. Ooh. I think. Oh. Just for this red, it's worth getting the palette. And then on the darker part, I'm just going to tap it on. I don't have any glitter primer there. Oh, this makes me so happy. Okay, what do I want? I wanted to use this color too. Just don't really know how. I want to use the color We as well, which is the white. And I kind of want to use that in my inner corner. So I have space left. I have a very tiny brush. Now I do have to say that I have a little bit of glitter primer there in the area where I'm going to place it now. So it sticks extra. So let's put it here because I haven't done anything there. Wow. Pretty decent white, people. I'm going to fade it up just a tiny bit. And I'm going to press it on top of the red shimmer. Yeah, that gives a nice effect. Usually I put a shimmer in the inner corner as well, but I think I really, really like this. Now for the bottom. I don't know yet. I don't really know what I want to do for my lower lash line just yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the same on this eye. Finish off the base. Put on liner and mascara. And then figure out what I want to do with the bottom lashes. And then you will see me again. Yes. So here is the look just before the falsies. And I added a black eyeliner. Black pencil just here in my waterline. And I kind of used the black shade of the palette to, well, set it a bit. So that is what I did. And a tiny little wing, some mascara. So yeah, I'm going to put on my falsies. And then here is the completed look. The falsies I have on are from Primark. They are my more dramatic style, but they kind of have that nice flare that I wanted. So yeah, for lips, ColourPop Lippy Stick Matte in the color Cookie. And the lippy I kind of wanted to keep soft and a little bit with a hint of, I don't know, a foxy orange. So yeah. I really like how this turned out. I haven't worn a very bold red look in ages, feels like. So yeah, I'm going to rock this for the rest of the day. This was the first look with this gorgeous palette from VE Cosmetics. Let me know down below what you think of this look and let's get ready for the next one. And I have done my base largely today because I'm also trying out the Miracle Foundation from Max Factor. And I kind of want to see how much it sets before I powder. So that is why I basically did all the cream things now. So yeah, I also have that in my hair because I haven't cleaned it yet. That's the way it is today. I am going to start, however, with my refer number 15. And the shade called Beauty. I'm tapping off my brush now because I have done my base and I'm going to place this as a transition shade but a little bit lower. Now my eyeshadow base isn't as tacky as it usually is because I have put it on and I haven't set it, but it I put it on before I put on my base. So it has time to set, so it is slightly sticky but not really tacky anymore. I don't know, it has a kind of a grip without being wet. A very pretty shade. And it blends out beautifully. Okay, let's go to my refer number 14. Let's grab the shade Together to deepen it up a tiny bit. Back to the first brush and a little bit more of the color Beauty. Now I'm going to grab my Morphe E36 and the shade called Will. It's going to go underneath my eye, my lower lash line. Let's blend it out a bit with a refer number 13. And let's just grab a little bit more. Let's connect it up. Oh no, we have been discovered. Hello, honey.
I can smell you a mile away.
Yes.
Like a shark. What you do, honey?
I'm putting on eyeshadow.
I'm starting to get really hairy.
Yes.
What did you see today?
It is today, it is this. And it is this palette.
It's a fox.
Yes, it's a fox.
I also have a fox.
Yes. It's almost the same colors as I'm using today.
So now I like it because it has a fox.
Yes, I understand. I understand completely. Go shower, black bananas. Let's go next to the shade Wheel again. And let's put it all over the lid. Okay. Then back to the first brush. I'm going to blend it out. Let's grab the color called Visible. With a dry brush. And let's put it here. I'm actually going to put it on top of the orange. And it doesn't seem to mess with the orange base shade too much, which is the reason that I am using it the way I'm using it now. And it is almost the same color in a shimmer as the first matte that I used, the Color Beauty. For eye pencil, the BH Cosmetics Power Pencil in silver, because I don't have a white. Then I'm going to go into the color called This. Let's plop that in the inner corner. On top of the pencil. I'm just smoking out the pencil a tiny bit. And then this is it for the eyes. Let me finish everything off. And I will show you the look just before I put on my falsies. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. So here's the look just before the falsies. And the eyeliner kind of spawned. I started with a tiny baby wing. And then it grew. So yeah, what I did do though is a little bit of that orange I smudged a little bit heavier underneath the lash line to help combat the heaviness going on upstairs. But yeah, now I have to pick out falsies and the lippy, so let me do that and then I will be back and show you the finished look. Hopefully it will all kinda come together a bit better. Yes. Oh, I forgot highlighter. Really? Oh no. God damn it, I did not know it would be so difficult to pick out a freaking pair of falsies when I have a big ass wing. Always looks good on Betty Jean, but yeah. I'm not Betty Jean now, am I?
One debt to society later.
So everything is on and here is the finished look. Definitely not what I had planned when I sat down to film this morning. I thought it's Sunday, I still have my pajama bottoms on and let's just, you know, put a look together. And now I'm in full glam. With pajama bottoms on. But yeah, the lippy I ended up picking is one from Ofra in the color Miami Fever. It's an orangey brown. I have no freaking idea of if I like how the look turned out. I think I do. But again, I don't even know. I had a hard time picking out falsies as well. I don't know if these complement the look or not. But yeah, they're on and they're staying on for the rest of the day. So this was look number two. Let me know down below what you thought of it. And let's get ready. For look number three. Look number three. I have already primed my eyes and look number three is going to be, well, basically orangey and black. So, yeah. Let's start with the orange. Let's start with a light layer of the color Off. As a transition shade. Okay, let's go to a slightly smaller brush and still the same color. Let's brighten everything up. I'm going to focus it more on the inner part of my eye. And then fade it out a little bit to the back, but still high. Okay. Now for the black, which is called Fight. I'm going to start on my lid. And then I'm going to blend it in the crease a bit, I hope, at least. I'm actually taking a clean brush to blend it. And then back to this one. And a tiny bit of the black. And I'm just basically patting it into place. Then I'm switching to the clean one again. And just concentrate on blending the edges. Then I'm grabbing my small brush just to connect my bottom lid to my upper. Let's smoke it out a bit. Let's go back to the first brush and a little bit of the color off. Second brush, same color, and blend it a little bit on top of the black. Okay, next I'm getting my NYX glitter primer. And what I'm actually going to do is I'm only going to use it in the inner part to clean up a little bit. Flipping my brush. Okay, and now I'm going to tap. Then I'm going to go into the shade called In. I'm concentrating it in the inner eye part and then I'm going to kind of fade it out on top of the black by tapping. Okay, let's grab the black. I just want a little bit more. Then I'm going to my clean brush. With this one, I'm going to go here just to help that line a little. I want a black eye pencil. So, okay, black eye pencil. This one is from number 7, but it does not really matter. Okay. Then let's go in both. So let's go to this one and this one. So here is one eye with liner and mascara. I'm going to put on falses, which are going to be these. These are my Kylie's from Primark. So let me put those on. And the reason I'm going to do it this way is because I'm also going to film my foundation review of the Max Factor Miracle. This one. Focus. Thank you. So that I can kind of start that video with two eyes done. So yeah. And to save camera time, I'm going to do this eye on camera and then this eye off camera. And I need to find my glue. So everything is on and here is the completed look. I thought let's bust out an orange lippy again. I haven't worn a bright orange in ages. And this is the L'Oreal Rouge Signature in the color I Achieve. Which is like, it feels like a lip stain. You can use it opaque, but you can also nicely build it up as you see me having here. It was a very weird sentence that, but yeah. For now, get ready for look number 4. Yes, 2 more to go. Yeah, look 4. Look 4. And if you hear weird noise outside, it's the seagulls. They are having a party. Eyes are primed and ready to go. I'm going to start with the color The as a transition shade. I don't have a lot of time. Hence the fact that I've already done my eyes. I have about 15 minutes before I need to go be in the grocery store. So I kind of need to hurry it up. It's not the first time though. This is a very much more of an yellowy orange almost. It's very cute. I'm just going to blend it out on the edge just to make sure it's nice and it flows nice into my skin. Okay, then I'm going to kind of load up my brush a bit more. I'm going to place it lower. It's a nice vibrant orange. I do want it a little bit of depth, but I don't really want to alter the color too much. Do I though, or do I just leave it like this? You know what, let's just leave it like this, because usually I kind of want to add depth, but let's not. Let's be funky today. Yes. I'm grabbing my NYX glitter primer and a flat brush. Wow, this is so bad. I'm going to tap it off, but I don't really want, or at least that's what I'm saying. I always say that I don't want a structured look, but yeah, I'm going to carve out a half cut crease anyway with my glitter primer. Let's first put a silver eye pencil in my waterline, BH Cosmetics. Okay, let's go to the color Your, which is the orangey shimmer. Oh. It's the same kind of tone as the mat. Okay, let's get that big brush in the matte color called The to just blend over the edge a little. Very, very pretty color. I have the silver left, so let's grab a pencil brush in the color This. I'm starting here where I have a little bit of glitter primer left. I'm using the pencil as a base as well. I usually don't do this, but that's okay. Okay. Then I'm going to go into the purpley shimmer that I just used for the outer part. And also to fade it up a bit. And I know I use a glitter primer, but actually with these shades, I don't really need them for the sticking part. I more need them for the not hoping that they rub off because my eyes are older part. Yes. Okay. Let's grab a brush and the silver shimmer. Because I just want to make sure that they kind of blend a little bit better. So I'm going to blend them a little bit better. Okay, then a little bit in the matte. Just the same brush, it doesn't really matter. Cool. 10 minutes to spare. But I need to do that eye as well. So let's do that. I do really like this though. And what I think they captured really, really well with this palette is the nuances in the red fur of the fox. Because it's not just red, it's orange. It is this kind of orange. It is, there is a yellowy gold in there. It's just, they did a very good job. And the quality is amazing, so yeah. So here is the look with mascara and liner before the falsies. Which I'm going to put on now. I think I'm going to go pretty natural, but I'm not sure yet. So I'm going to pick out falsies, choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the finished look. Falsies are on, and for lip liner I just grabbed the Catrice Lip Foundation Pencil in Caramel Blonde to go. And then I'm going to wear my lippy stick from Colourpop in the color Cookie. And then that is the look. I could have gone a little bit more dramatic with the falsies, but I thought, let's not today. Let's kind of keep it soft. I don't know what's happening to me, but yeah. I do really, really like this look. Let me know down below what you think of it, and let's get ready for look number 5. The last look of the video. And the last look is going to be... I'm going to play here. Largely. And then we will see from there. Eyes are primed and ready to go. I'm going to start with... We're going to start with a bigger brush. And the color called Vixen. I don't know if it is the yellow or my primer. But it almost does not want to stick in certain places. So I'm just going to tap it on. It is a very pigmented yellow. But again, I don't know if it is reacting... because maybe my base is still a little bit too wet. I don't know. I'm just going to work with it. So I'm just going to blend slightly. Without much pressure. And if I need a little bit more yellow, I will put it back on. I do want it to be vibrant. Maybe I need a softer, less denser brush. This one is clean. It's a very soft... brush. Maybe this will help with the blend a bit, because it almost looks like it's clinging to my eyeshadow primer, that my eyeshadow primer is maybe still a little bit too tacky in some places. So there's that. It's worse on one eye than on the other, so I don't really know what's happening there. Yeah, it still feels a little bit sticky. Actually almost tempted to remove it, so I'm actually going to. Because this is not good. So let's stop the video. Okay, so I removed the base with just a little bit of water and one of these. To keep it a little bit dry. And I used less of my eyeshadow primer. Because it could very well be that I just used too much. I have let it set a little while longer. So now I feel that it is still that it is still a bit sticky, but it's not really wet. So let's try again. Again, my refer, and again the color Vixen. Maybe I will go in a little bit lighter now as well. And the reason that I did this and I'm showing you this, because I want you to see what happens sometimes and how to fix it. And yes, it makes the video a little bit longer, but then again, you learn something, so that's good. I'm still going to tap it on, but as you see, I have a lighter layer now. I'm going to build it up, and I can already feel my brush not dragging as much. So let me build it up, and we shall see what happens. Yeah, I can already see, yeah, you can see here a little bit of discoloration. That is because my base is still a little bit too wet, and that changes the base shade of the yellow. It happens a lot, actually. It's not the shadow's fault, it's just the way that they react. But I can already see that it lays down much smoother than before, so it was the base. So now I can build it up to what I want. It's not that difficult. I'm pressing it on, and then I'm kind of blending it a little bit. And that is it, you know, you only need a very, very little bit of primer. You don't need the Instagram. If you are having trouble with your shadows, try less primer. If you don't wear an eyeshadow primer but use a concealer, try an eyeshadow primer. If you are having trouble with your MAC paint pot, use less. Okay, so that's a lot better than it was. It is a little bit more built up, so that is very, very good. And I'm looking redonkulous, but I don't care. I do want to deepen it up. We will see how I go. I'm going to go to the color Together. And I have an idea in mind, I just don't know if I'm able to execute it. So let me actually go to my refer number 13, which is a bit smaller. And I'm basically just starting here in the outer corner thingy part of Majingy, and then going up and then going in. For my eye shape. And I know it's looking a little bit like that, but I will fix it in a minute. Because I want it a little bit rounder. And I'm laying down the color now, and I'm just mapping it out basically. So that when I look forward, let's see, yeah, it can be a little bit higher, actually. So let's do it a little bit higher here. Okay, then I'm getting a clean brush. Just going to blend the edge. Before I go and build up that reddish shade, I just want to have the blend down, so that I don't have to blend that part again. Then I'm going to go back to the previous brush. And just make sure that that blend is the way I want it. Okay. Now I'm going to build it up. So I'm going to look down. I'm going to place the shadow. But below the part where I just blended. Now don't mind it getting messy on my lid, because I'm going to clean it up in a minute anyway. So I'm slightly going over the line that I blended. And because I can blend these shades no problem. I just don't really want to. So that is why I'm doing it the way that I'm doing it now. Now I'm going to go to my Morphe E36. My small brush, still in the same color. Which is a little bit harder pressed, but I do pick up nicely. And I'm going to, in the middle of that color, going to build up the color even more. Then I'm going to go back to a cleanish blending brush. And basically I'm just going to make it the way that I want it. So blending, placing, blending, placing. Because of course I kind of changed my mind again. So I do kind of want to blend this a little bit more up, but not too far. And that is why I'm holding my brush like that and not like that. I'm so happy it was my base and not a shitty yellow. I like this palette so much, I don't want to have a dot in it, you know? Cool. Okay, with my Morphe E36, I'm going... Am I done? No, I'm actually going to grab a Morphe, what is it, 507. I'm going to go into the black called Fight. Because I kind of want to add a little bit of depth. And now I feel like McDonald's, and I don't want that. I don't like McDonald's at all. I just want a tiny bit, not a lot. So that is it. I'm going to clean my brush on the towel. I'm going to use that. It's going to be a fire eye. Phoenix eye. Well, I am born in the year of the fire dragon, so yeah, it's kind of appropriate. Now I have the colors of Germany. Wow. Doesn't matter. I'm just going to kind of darken up that red a bit. Okay, back to the brush that I used with the red. Okay, it's coffee. I do want to lay down a little bit of black here in the outer eye part area to go underneath the shimmer. So I'm just going to press it on or tap it on a little bit. And I'm actually going to drag it a little bit more into the crease. So when I do a half cut crease in a minute, you can kind of still see it a little, I hope. I need a little bit of that red. This is the most complicated look that I'm doing with this palette, with only 4 colors. So, or at least for now, 4 colors. Okay, now I'm getting my glitter primer and the flat brush. And I'm going to do a half cut crease. It was not what I had planned when I sat down the film, but I think I'm going to like it anyway. Nice and dramatic again. I'm going to go to the color called Eyes, which is the yellow gold shimmer. It's going to go on top. Here I'm just going to kind of tap it over a bit. So now I'm going to recreate this on that eye. Finish off the base. Put on liner and mascara. And probably a yellow eye pencil or a red. I haven't decided, but I think it's going to be a yellow. And now the crows are having a party. Here is the look just before the falsies. And yeah, as you can see, I kind of did what I did here, there as well. So black eye pencil, kind of smudge it out a little bit with the black eyeshadow. Then put that red underneath to blend that out. And then the yellow underneath. So basically what I did here, I did there as well. Inner corner highlight is my Revolution Skin Finish, because it is a little bit goldeny without being yellowy. And I kept kind of the base colors a little bit softer to keep the focus on the eyes. I kind of like that. But yeah, I am going to put on my falsies now, which I kind of need to think about, and choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the final look and we can close off the video. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Falsies are on, lippy is on, and here is the finished look. I really like it. I like the dramaticness that I have going on today. For lips, I chose the MUA Luxe Velvet Lip Lacquer in the color Poise, which is a brownie, but it is a little bit of a yellowy brownie. I don't know, but I really like the color. So yeah, that's the one I chose. And I chose my more dramatic falsies in the style Kylie that I get from Primark, because I think it all balances out very, very well like this. This was the last look of the video, guys. I had so much fun playing with this palette. I think I created 5 very pretty looks, and that was it. If you want to know my thoughts, check out the eye swatching video that I did. And at the end of that video, I give you my review on this palette as well. Let me know down below if you have a favorite look. Let me know if you have the palette and all that goodness. For now, thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.